It's our annual birthday toast to Bob Collins on this Tuesday, February the 28th. Hard to believe Bob would have been 81 today. That's all. He's been gone 23 years now. Everybody remembers that February 8th day in 2000. And Dave, did you start this toast tradition? I can't remember.
Yeah, you know, he did.
I don't remember exactly the first time we did it, but I've become the keeper of the bottle. It used to be in the possession of Orion Samuelson, and Orion and I had adjoining offices back in the Tribune Tower, and so we were in charge of keeping the bottle and replenishing the bottle for this birthday toast every year.
Is there a year on that thing?
Well, it wouldn't matter now because the booze is, like you said, blended.
But yes, but there's always, the way I figure it, there is some of the original product is still in that bottle, mixed in with newer product.
Yes.
And again, that bottle was in the Bob Collins desk.
It was basically the only thing in Bob's desk.
And I'm wondering, Orion, if you occasionally had a little sip of that early in the morning.
Well, no, I wouldn't do that. Of course I would not, because that was a sacred piece of whatever. And so I would not partake of it without a special reason. And I'm delighted that we started the procedure of remembering Bob on this date. And I'm pleased that Dave is keeping whatever is left of that one and only bottle that we found in Bob's desk safe and still with us. So it was the year 2000, February 28th, that Bob passed away. That's 23 years ago. I remember the date well. I remember the conversation I had had with Bob, because at that time I would do my reports until the 8 o'clock news, and I distinctly remember that Bob looked out the window of our Tribune Tower studio, and he said, boy, this is a nice day. I think we'll go flying. And so he said, Orion, why don't you go flying with me? And I said, you know I can't do that because I have to be here for the noon show, so I'll take a pass on it. And then later on that day, the saddest day of my life.
Mm-hmm. And, Orion, I know you recall back in 1974, that's when Bob Collins joined WGN, and at first you didn't know quite to make of him, did you?
My reaction, and this is why I never became a radio station manager, because the first time I heard Bob, I thought, oh my golly, it's the end of WGN, because here was that down-home cackle that he would insert after almost everything he did on the air. And so I thought, my God, is this what WGN has come to? And I said, that's the end of this. So I know I was not very high. One, I have so many memories of Bob, because when he had been at WGN a few days, I had a broadcast coming at the Walworth County Fair in Walworth, Wisconsin. And I decided, since I talked about what I was doing, I'd invite Bob to go along. So I invited him to go along, and he went with me and went up to the Walworth County Fair. And I thought, you know, they don't know who Bob Collins is, so I think I'll introduce him. So I brought him up on stage with Lino Prigo and the Musical Wheels and Dolph Hewitt and the Stage Riders, and I introduced him to the crowd, and it was kind of interesting because he hemmed and hawed around, and when we got done with our exchange in front of the crowd and we came off the stage, he came up to me and he said, Samuelson, if you ever do that to me again, I'll kill you.
Well, let's do the toast. And what's in everybody's glass here again?
Well, this is the Jack Daniels. This is the my favorite memory still Orion, you and I replenishing the product in the bottle using an upside-down birthday hat as a funnel.
You're right.
And the whiskey ate right through the cardboard.
Yes. All right. It was not an easy job to make sure we had some of the original in the bottle that still remained. And you and I worked, I think, very diligently on getting that done.
Exactly.
Next year, can I propose that we have nicer glasses than these? We have little sample cups. Well, little plastic sample
historic
cups.
Historic occasion.
Shot glasses.
They're supposed to look old. All right, John Williams with us. I would rather have a root beer, to be honest with you. But, Orion, why don't you lead us in the happy birthday toast here to Bob Collins?
All right, because it all started with Uncle Bobby back in the year 2000, and we enjoyed his company on the air and off the air. And Bob and I had a goal. We were going to sit in Arizona when we retired, and we were going to watch the desert go by. We're going to have to wait a little while to get that done, I hope. But anyway, may I drink a toast to the best friend ever.
81 years old, he would have been today. Happy birthday to Bob Collins. We're all raising the glass now. Let's have the toast.
Cheers. Here we go. Right. Bottoms
clink,
up.
Clink, 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 clink. Thank you, Orion. Yeah. It's going to be a...
Thank you for the opportunity.
Not part of my routine.
No, not usually.
Fun end of our broadcast today, and I'm sure the John Williams Show will get off to a good start today.
You know, Bob was a rebel, and it's appropriate that he would have a bottle of Jack Daniels, and that in his name we would do something like this before my show starts or in the middle of yours. So,
do you need more, John?
No. Cheers to Bob, and thank you. Oh, it's good to hear your voice, and we know you loved him.
And
Yeah, Orion, be well. Stay healthy, my friend.
Thanks, Big O.
And all of you do the same.